Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Monday Night Raw. We are here live, and we have some exciting things that are going to come down tonight. We are live from Baton Rouge, Louisiana. Kyle Matthews, Christopher Pierce, thank you guys for joining me here for Raw.
We are fresh on Royal.
Holy cow!
Right off the bat, those technical difficulties.
Yeah, that was like robot. I thought we were sitting next to the Terminator.
Well, you know, I thought that after Kyle took part in that Royal Rumble match yesterday, maybe that has something to affect his voice. Maybe that wasn't even the mic. Maybe someone crushed his voice box.
Oh, but we have our new world champion out here. What's he got to say? Strong words there by Triple H. He's the champion, but still doesn't feel like he's the head man.
Apparently not.
Once again, some tough words from Triple H, but how we get started with some actual action here with, and here comes the club. They're taking on the tag team champions in the Dudley Boys. So this should be quite an exciting match.
Yeah, good way for the good opportunity for the club here. But with the victory over the Dudley Boys, they could potentially put themselves in contention for the tag titles.
No doubt about that. And I'll tell you, you know, I'm still a little confused by Triple H's words. I mean, he's the champion, but apparently he feels that, I don't know if he feels that his victory was tainted and it wasn't earned. I'm not really sure where Triple H is coming from, to be honest, but...
Well, like I said before, you know, he's a champion, maybe he feels like he deserves more. You know, when you align yourself with somebody like Michael Norman, you know, it's no doubt that you could get a little greedy.
This is true.
I don't know what more you can get, though. I mean, Triple H is at the top of the mountain overgrowing Raw right now, so I don't know how it can get any better.
Well, maybe Triple H wants all of the titles.
Well, let's keep in mind, too, I mean, we've just come off the heels of the Royal Rumble. WrestleMania is going to be coming up pretty soon, so, I mean, maybe Triple H is...
On the road to WrestleMania, yep.
Maybe Triple H has got something, you know, that he wants to do at Mania or something? I don't know. I mean, the board's kind of open to interpretation, to be honest.
Yeah, I'll definitely have to find out what Triple H has in store, and more importantly, what Michael Norman has in store, because don't forget, he is the winner of the Royal Rumble.
Absolutely right.
As you see the Dudley Boys and the club getting ready to get it on, referee Mr. Wright rings the bell, and Bubba starts out with a hard DDT.
And of course,
you know, we
the
have
Dudley
so
Boys,
much, so the- much things going on in the y.W.c. on the road to WrestleMania. You know, there's actually a special event coming up, y.w.c roadblock. And yeah. Seth, would you like to tell us a little more about it?
Yeah, it's going to be an interpromotional pay-per-view, just kind of right in the middle between Royal Rumble and WrestleMania. Not really a whole lot in, as far as, you know, storylines that we've seen in Raw and SmackDown. Actually, it's almost kind of like a Raw versus SmackDown kind of thing. We're going to be seeing the United States champion of SmackDown going up against the Intercontinental champion of Raw. I mean, it's going to be pretty interesting. A lot of interesting events. And I was going to say Ernest Wright will be there, but maybe not.
He's up. He's a trooper.
Luke Gallows just flat ran him over there.
Luke Gallows taking no prisoners.
Nope. Don't know what he has against zebras.
Also, find out too that that YWC Roadblock is going to take place Tokyo, Japan.
Yeah, going across the seas, doing a interpromotional international pay-per-view. So that's going to be a lot of fun.
So how the hell did we afford that?
That's what I was wondering.
Not exactly sure how. I mean, I know the ratings have been going up for YWC. Maybe that has something to do with it.
I wonder if maybe somebody robbed a bank. Kyle, we've been out robbing banks again.
Huh. I know somebody who suggested that, but no, I'm not into that kind of thing.
If that's how Kyle entered in the Royal Rumble, maybe someone said, "I'll let you have a Royal Rumble entry if you end up going and robbing a
Runnable.
Bank."
Runnable. Hit Royal Runnable.
Runnable.
Runnable. I wonder if Kyle's been sipping too much of the booty juice.
I don't know. Only Kyle would be able to tell us that. But I don't know if he would.
Not familiar with that kind of thing either. I don't know what you're getting at. Sidewalk slam there. Luke Gallows on Devon Dudley.
And of course, let's not forget the Dudley boys, they knocked off Kane and The Undertaker back at Extreme Rules. I mean,
yeah, they did.
A lot of us, you know, were given the odds in favor of the Brothers of Destruction, but the Dudleys ended up doing something that really, let's be honest, for weeks, none of us thought was possible.
They didn't knock them off at Extreme Rules, they knocked them off on last week on Raw.
Oh, it was on Raw, that's right, yeah.
In a tables match.
Actually, it was an Extreme Rules match. That had, okay. It was an Extreme Rules match that had tables. Let's put it that way.
But from what I understand, we're actually going to be hearing from both Kane and The Undertaker tonight, so we'll see what that's all about. Yeah. Plus, let's not forget, I mean, in the Royal Rumble match last night, Kane and The Undertaker actually went up against each other. You know, they didn't really work together.
Oh, really? But then again, you know, it is the Royal Rumble, and it is every man for himself.
That's true.
Yeah, I wish they would have focused more on each other during that time at the Rumble.
Yeah, I'm sure you do.
Yeah, Kyle. Good old Brothers of Destruction not taking too kindly to Kyle.
No.
Especially Kane. I don't know what I did to him, but
you were just... You probably look like a pork chop to Kane. Dudley's starting to come back here a little bit. Taking in now Devon. We see some double team action here. Oh, Bubba just picks him up. Picks up Carl Anderson.
And of course, we know that obviously with the Brothers of Destruction being the former champs, you'd think they would be in line for a rematch at some point against the Dudley boys. But I mean, if Carl Anderson and Luke Gallows are able to knock them off here tonight, you got to think that at some point down the road, they might be in line for a tag team championship match.
Oh, look at Carl Anderson just take out Bubba, but Devon able to kick out. Yeah, I guess it all comes down to what we're going to see or what we're going to hear from The Undertaker and Kane later tonight.
Yep.
Oh, Carl Anderson depositing Bubba Ray out of the ring.
Well, I thought they were going to double-team Devon right there, but Anderson able to get back to his corner. Devon now fighting back against Luke Gallows.
I wonder. Excuse me. I wonder what could wonder what they could be thinking here. Ooh, oh, snake eyes there by Demon. Head bouncing right off the top turnbuckle there. And Bubba drops an elbow.
And let's also not forget the strategy that Devon and Bubba Ray used against The Undertaker and Kane, where they kind of really singled out one person, and then they were able to basically use a two-on-one situation. I mean, they really showed
that happen.
We've said, you know, that there are a lot of really well-formed teams here in the YWC, and I think that was just a classic case of that.
Yeah, we haven't really seen them trying to single out. They haven't been able to. Out of these two, they haven't really been able to single out a person yet, even though they've tried.
Oh, boy, look at this. I don't know what Luke Gallows is thinking, but I have a feeling it's not good.
Oh! The big boot. But Bubba Ray able to counter.
Look at Devon Dugway in his corner. He looks pretty exhausted, like he might not even want a tag right now.
Well, he was in the matchup for quite a long time.
Oh, what's Luke Gallows looking at here? Hit him up, and he drives him down. Is that enough to knock off Bubba?
Go for the cover
on
him.
Go for the cover. Is it enough? It is.
Wow.
Devon didn't even really get in to try to help.
Well, like Kyle said, Devon didn't really, he looked the worst for wear out there on the apron.
Oh, well, the club was knocking off, the tag team champions. What could that mean? Possible championship implications maybe in the future? Who
Absolutely.
Knows?
Absolutely.
Yep, stick around. Stick around, we still got more Raw coming up. Welcome back to Raw, ladies and gentlemen. Up next, it's the first match of two tonight that's a part of the number one contender championship tournament here tonight. We're going to see Roman Reigns take on Seth Rollins.
These are two guys that know each other very well. Of course, think back to the old days of the Shield those two were a part of, so... Should be a fun match to watch.
Also kind of interesting, too. I mean, you know, we know that the current champion is Triple H, and in my mind, the current number one contender would obviously be General Manager Michael Norman with winning the Royal Rumble. My question is, if there's a set number one contender to face Triple H at Mania, why are we having a number one contenders tournament?
Because we still got to get through Fastlane.
This is true. I don't know, do you think maybe Michael Norman doesn't want to face Triple H at Mania?
It's going to happen at Mania. I don't know. We'll have to wait and see. Remember, Triple H also has to put his title on the line later tonight against AJ Styles. AJ Styles catching his rematch clause.
That's true.
But we still got Fastlane before. Fastlane before WrestleMania. We need a number one contender for Fastlane. YWC Fastlane. Remember, the roadblock is just a special event. It's not the actual pay-per-view
of the
month.
No, I'm aware of that, but my question is, you know, if we're having a number one contender to face Triple H, you know, provided he's able to beat AJ Styles tonight, it could be AJ Styles at Fastlane, is it possible that Michael Norman doesn't want to have to risk facing off against Triple H at WrestleMania? Because let's say that whoever wins this number one contenders tournament beats Triple H at Fastlane, then they would go on to face Michael Norman at WrestleMania.
Well, we know Michael Norman and Triple H are good friends, but, you know, even best friends have to get in the ring, you know, get in the ring and fight sometimes. So, I can't speak for him. I have no clue what Michael Norman's plan is right now, but it's a good possibility something like that could happen.
Yeah, I think probably the only person who knows what Michael Norman's plan is Michael Norman himself.
And maybe Triple H.
I don't even know if he might not even let Triple H in on some of the secrets.
We'll definitely see, but the first round of the number one contender tournament is set to get underway.
Seth making his mount on the ring, and he had the unfortunate situation last night at the Rumble, drawing number one. What started things off against the Big Show, of all people.
Yeah.
Yeah. That wasn't good for Seth Rollins. But if he could win this match and advance into the tournament, he could still have enough time to face the champion, whoever that may be.
Absolutely right, but he's having to go up against fellow Shield brethren, or former Shield brethren, I guess I should say, in Roman Reigns. And Roman Reigns had himself a pretty decent Royal Rumble matchup. Came in, I don't remember exactly what he drew,
but it was 28.
Yeah, it was something like that. Yeah, it was in the late 20s.
Roman Reigns came in 28, got eliminated by Michael Norman when he after entry number 30 came out, which was Michael Norman, of course. Got himself eliminated, so Roman Reigns' hopes were dashed on trying to main event WrestleMania. I'm going to have to wait and see how things progress here. Roman Reigns really taking it to Seth Rollins right now. Oh, just as I say that, Rollins with a nice reversal.
I mean, let's not forget Seth Rollins, the architect. I mean, he knows Roman Reigns very well. Roman Reigns knows Seth Rollins very well. So I don't think either one of these guys are going to be really able to get one up on each other because of, you know, the past history they have with each other.
Yeah. I'll wait and see, though. Roman Reigns going up top.
Yeah, we don't see him go to the top rope very often.
And he gets Seth Rollins to stand up. What could Roman Reigns be thinking? Oh.
Took a diving clothesline.
Yep. Oh, and look at this. Yeah, Roman's... Does Roman think he's going to put Seth Rollins away already?
Could be, trying to fire up the crowd.
Seems very confident.
Oh, neck breaker. We're starting to see a classic roll. This is going to say that again. Oh! Two reversals by two people. Let's say, now we're starting to see classic Roman Reigns begin to dominate. Jeez. What a right fist.
You know, I was thinking, too, going to tonight's main event where we've got AJ Styles, you know, invoking his rematch clause against Triple H. Oh, my goodness, nice takedown there by Rollins. But remember back to last Monday Night Raw when it was Triple H versus AJ Styles and there was that kind of swerve where even we didn't know that it was a no disqualification type matchup until last minute. I mean, I don't want to say Triple H is afraid of AJ Styles, but do you think that there's something in the works of maybe something sneaky like that happening again? Is there's a Superman punch?
Oh, yeah, it definitely took down Seth Rollins. I have no clue. We'll never know.
Rollins might be in trouble here.
Rollins could be
here's
in
a
trouble.
Spear!
And that could do it. This match could be over just like that. But Roman, oh, now he's going for the car. I was going to say, why isn't he pinning him?
Roman Reigns going for the cover, and Seth Rollins just kicks out.
Roman Reigns can't believe it. He thought he had this match won after that, but Seth Rollins showing a lot of resiliency here.
Yeah, he and I both thought that he had this matchup won, but apparently not the case.
Roman Reigns going right after the face of Seth Rollins.
Now after, I thought he was going to go for a DDT, but almost into a snap suplex. You got to wonder if Seth Rollins, after suffering the Superman punch in the spear, if he's going to be able to come back from that, mount some kind of offense. Right now, it's like he kind of is. That. Oh man! What a super kick!
Reigns able to kick out it too.
Well, what could Seth Rollins be thinking? Seth Rollins goading the crowd now. Could Seth Rollins think he could put away Roman Reigns here soon?
I spent a little too much time there, though. Now there's a roll-up.
Oh, with a roll-up.
Yeah, never even got a one count.
Oh, what's Roman, what's Seth Rollins thinking here? He's thinking
yeah,
pedigree.
For a pedigree.
And he hits it.
Hit the pedigree. Hit the pedigree on Roman Reigns. Is that enough to put Roman away?
Well, look at this.
He didn't go for the cover, surprisingly.
He's going for a submission instead. Just wringing the head and neck area of Reigns. Now he's going for the pin.
Oh, Roman kicks out at one.
Oh, where is
Seth?
What's Seth
Rollins thinking?
Oh my!
Wow!
Just barely hidden Roman Reigns, but he certainly got him. And
yes,
look at
he did.
Whoa! What a move! Snap! A weird-looking snap suplex.
Oh, look at Reigns. Oh, look at the power of Reigns.
Goes right for the pin immediately. Roman looks like he's busted open.
I believe he is. Yeah, right there on the forehead.
I think he got busted open from the pedigree. I'm not certain.
Tied up, but Roman Reigns is bleeding. And remember what we talked about before. At the sight of your own blood, it can really change you into a totally different person.
You take things to a whole new level.
You literally see red.
Yes.
No pun intended. Uh-oh. What's Roman thinking here?
Oh, my.
Oh!
Wow.
Referee, get in position.
That's
Is that enough
do
to
it.
Put Seth Rollins
oh.
away? Oh, and Seth kicks out at two.
Wow, I don't know how he kicked out of that.
Roman Reigns trying to guilt the crowd again. Maybe this time he feels he's got it. He's got the match put away.
Reigns heading over to the corner. Might be setting
Uh-oh.
Up for a second spear.
Second spear. Is it going to happen?
Got him.
Oh,
no,
no, he,
no
did.
He didn't.
Seth Rollins reversed. Rollins reversed.
Rollins, that scouted out perfectly.
My goodness.
Uh-oh. That's where I was setting up for the buckle bomb. Buckle bomb connects the Roman Reigns. Usually that's followed by the curb stomp, but Seth thinks he's got it won already.
Ooh.
And now Roman kicks out it too.
Boy, and look at Rollins trying to figure out what do I got to do to put Reigns away. I countered the
Uh-oh.
Spear. Hit him with the buckle bomb. What more do I have to do?
Oh, Seth Rollins!
Curb stomp! That's gotta be it! That's gotta do it! Oh! What?
Oh my goodness!
What?
Roman Reigns kicked out of the curb stomp.
I do not believe what
this
I just saw.
This is amazing. We saw early on in the match, you know, Reigns hit the Superman punch and then the spear, and that couldn't put Rollins away. Now Rollins hitting him with the curb stomp and a buckle bomb, and that couldn't put Roman Reigns away.
And he hit him with the pedigree earlier in the match, too. Boy, that's got to really, really air buff Seth Rollins right now, because what has he got to do to put away Roman Reigns? Both of these guys want to be number one contender.
I mean, both these guys have hit each other with just about their top pieces of offense, and Roman Reigns, after just kicking Seth Rollins off, going for a cover, that's not going to be enough to put him away.
Probably not. Remember, Roman Reigns still bleeding, so it could be just a matter of time before blood loss comes into play.
Could very well, you're right. We know about the endurance of Roman Reigns, but yeah, every time that his heart
pumps,
he's losing more blood, and that's taking away
his
stamina and energy.
Rollins just tearing away at the cut on Roman Reigns' face. Oh, we're going to see it again? Another buckle bomb. Bam, right there. Hits it. Another buckle bomb. Seth Rollins is also, if you see the fatigue setting in, is it enough to put Roman away? No,
oh,
Roman still kicks out at
goodness.
Two.
What do these guys have to do?
I have no idea. Oh, what's Seth Rollins thinking about now?
For another curb stomp? What the?
Ernest!
Oh my!
Speak to us!
Holy cow!
Rest in peace, Ernest Wright!
I shouldn't be laughing, but
no,
that was
you
hilarious.
Shouldn't be laughing!
But that was hilarious! Just out of nowhere, and he's up again to the count. Is it over? Yes,
and he gets it finally.
Oh,
what a battle!
Poor Ernest Wright. Well, Seth Rollins
advances. I cannot believe that.
Seth Rollins advances in the tournament, and Ernest Wright
is going
to the doctor. I'm not trying to laugh. We still got more to come here on Monday Night Raw. As you can see, the contender tournament right now, Seth Rollins advances. Well, now comes the pivotal point in the evening, something we've been looking forward to. What does The Undertaker have on his mind since losing the Tag Team Championship back last week on Monday Night Raw?
Doesn't look too happy.
No, not at all.
Then again, he never looks happy, but anyway.
Undertaker calling out Kane.
Yeah.
Already.
Well, ask and you shall receive.
This could get explosive.
Kyle, why are you sinking down into your chair? It's not coming for you.
Yeah, stop it. You're fine tonight. Don't worry, you're not in a mask.
Jimmy will protect you.
Yeah, I'll protect you from the other side of the arena. I don't know, maybe this is exactly what these two need. Air some grievances now, maybe try to get back on the same page.
Oh my!
And here we go. Things beginning to kick off here.
Well, I think they cleared the air. They told each other exactly what they felt about, and I don't think either one really appreciated it.
Nope, not at all. These two brothers, this is explosive in the ring. Look at Kane. Kane fighting back.
This is not good. Two of the most formidable figures on the Raw roster made them even more formidable when they were tagging up together and became the tag team champions, but now it looks like they are completely disintegrating.
I guess this answers our question from earlier about the tag team championship.
I think you might be right.
I think everybody on the tag team roster is, they can't be upset to be seeing this.
Undertaker trying to fight back here. See. Drops the elbow right down on Kane. We gotta get somebody out here to separate these guys.
I'm not sure anybody wants to get out here and separate these two.
Oh, jump in the
boot. I think Ernest Dryden is still seeing stars right now. I don't think he wants to come out here.
Good
look
grief.
At Kane.
He's already dealt with some people. Oh, look at Undertaker. Thought Undertaker might be actually running for a moment, but no, he's back in. And oh no, are you?
Uh-oh, he reversed it. Kane was picking Tombstone Piledriver.
Oh, what a clothesline!
And there's Ernest
Finally
Wright.
We get... Well.
Well, that really exploded into something. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to Monday Night Raw. It's now time for the second of two matches in the tournament, the number one contender tournament. Here comes the miracle, Mike Bennett, with his wife, Rhea.
First, we saw the miracle make his wife debut last night at the Royal Rumble, and now a bona fide signee on the y.W.c. Raw roster.
As same as his opponent tonight, Mr. Montel Fontavious Porter, MVP.
Couple of superstars that debuted at the Rumble. We get to see what they're going to be able to bring to the table in here in one-on-one action.
All I have to say is, Maria, why? What do you see in her?
Well, first off, he's got a job and probably a paycheck.
Well, as the theme song says, he's back as MVP, and not only is he back, but both of these guys get to be in this number one contender tournament. So you can only imagine how much these guys both would want to be number one contender.
And MVP also, as we said, made his debut at the Royal Rumble last night. Well, he actually had two eliminations in that Royal Rumble too, so a very good showing in his debut matchup, but tonight it's his debut Raw matchup, and he's just taking on Mike Bennett. And of course, we know that both of these guys know each other very well. They faced off against each other in the TNA organization.
Yep. That's what's going to make this match even more special. Mike Bennett, MVP, number one contendership tournament on the line. Ernest Wright, who apparently is doing a lot better, is back now and the match gets underway. Here's the thing, we've seen Maria in action before, with Maria being outside with her husband. Well, could that play any mental ability to help Mike Bennett and hurt MVP?
Could very well. It could also help prove a distraction for MVP at some point in this matchup.
Probably could provide a distraction for Jimmy Bly too.
Well, I think that's happened much sooner
allowed,
than tonight.
I'm not allowed to look anymore. Yeah, Maria came up to me and said, "Stop looking at me like you do on commentators. I've watched your shows. I've seen you drool over me. Stop it. I have my husband's here now, so go away."
Is that why your husband is here? Is what I want to know.
Yeah, that could be.
Well, let's just say that having Mike Bennett here probably wasn't Michael Norman's idea. Don't forget, we still have a commissioner, you know.
This is true. Of course, big opportunity for both of these debuting superstars to put themselves right into the world championship picture if they're able to advance in this tournament.
MVP, oh, that's already a submission on Mike Bennett. Oh, and Mike Bennett using the knees to get out of it.
Well, guys, we were speculating about, you know, what the whole tag team situation is going to look like, and it looks like maybe one of the most dominant tag teams we've had here on Raw Kane and The Undertaker, the Brothers of Destruction, like they're disbanding, going their own separate ways after a really volatile breakup just moments ago. So now that almost makes me wonder that with that victory that the club had over the Dudley Boys tonight, would that make it be, you know, maybe the setup for tag team titles on the line between those two groups, those two teams?
It could very
sense.
Well.
I mean, they were able to defeat the tag champs, so they totally earned the shot at it.
Yep, it could very well. You never know.
And I can only assume that this will possibly mean, with the fact that Undertaker and Kane no longer on the same page, they may not even, you know, invoke their rematch clause.
Oh, I doubt that. They're not going to get along at all. And one person isn't allowed to go after a championship alone. It's a tag team championship, that is.
I beg to differ.
Look at this. Oh, what an uppercut by Mike Bennett.
Remember that, I think it was a fatal four-way ladder match, and Kane went out, represented himself, and I think it was it Rob Van Dam at the time or something.
Oh, I don't remember that at all.
And he was the only member out there, and he won the titles.
That would have been because RVD got now backstage, right?
Yeah, I believe so, yeah.
Oh, look at Mike Bennett. He's got an MVP up and a sit-down Falcon Arrow style. Is it enough to put him away?
Ooh!
And all MVP kicks out.
Putting all of his weight on MVP with that cover, but MVP able to kick out.
Mike Bennett with the reversal.
Almost like he drove MVP's head down into the mat with his knee.
Yeah, he very well could have. Never know.
Right now, Mike Bennett. Oh, what? Oh,
oh, oh, super kick.
What a super kick. Boy, that... MVP able to get right back up from it. I thought that knocked him in the next week.
Yeah, I thought so too. He looked a little loopy when he went down, but somehow able to recover quickly.
I wonder if Ernest Wright is still seeing stars.
Well, let's see. We got Mike Bennett. We got MVP. We've got Maria. Yeah, there's at least three stars out there.
Funny.
Superstars, yeah, puns for days.
Bad jokes, haha. Look at the cross arm breaker in, and MVP able to escape out of it.
Of course, we've seen the that number one contenders tournament bracket. I'm quite surprised we actually didn't see your name on there, Kyle. I mean, after the showing you had at the Royal Rumble, I'm surprised that General Manager Michael Norman and Commissioner Trent Dunham didn't decide to put you in the tournament.
Yeah, I'm surprised they didn't put me in a match against Kane or The Undertaker or something, but, you know, that's just...
I think they still want you for it. I think they still need you for commentary. I don't think they want to kill you.
That's a good point there.
Oh, and a kick right to the sternum. That'll take away the ability to breathe, and then a stomp right to the face. Uh-oh, wait a minute. Oh! Wow, drop kick right to the side of the head.
MVP trying to work, remember. It's all going to come down to who wants to be number one contender the most. Who wants to continue on in this tournament?
I already know that Seth Rollins has advanced in the tournament.
Seth Rollins must have thought that the match him and Roman Reigns as was a triple threat. Must have thought that Ernest Wright was also in that match, but...
Yeah, I don't know what it is tonight. I don't know if it's pick on Ernest night or what, because, whoa, wait a minute. Oh, we got that crossface that MVP's got on Bennett?
Yeah, it looks like it.
My goodness, reversing into that. Nice job, MVP, to pick Mike Bennett out of the air. But yeah, I mean, Ernest Wright, he got ran over by Luke Gallows tonight. He's been curb stomped by Seth Rollins. I mean, the poor guy's not able to catch a break here tonight, it seems. It's what he gets for taking half the night off last night in the Rumble.
Yeah, right?
He's probably going to fill up a bathtub with nothing but ice water and get in that thing after tonight.
All right, well, you never know.
Oh, there's that uppercut again there. A spinning uppercut by Mike Bennett. I'll tell you what, right now, I mean, we've seen some nice reversals by MVP, but for the most part, this match has seemed to be in the corner of the miracle.
Yeah, Mike Bennett really been showing his stuff here. Look, just as you say that, another reversal to MVP, right during MVP, what looks to be a back body drop into a bulldog. You know, I guess the question remains is, do you believe in miracles? Oh, look at this. Ooh.
You know, Mike Bennett does. I mean, just look at the difference between this matchup and the matchup we saw with Reigns and Rollins. I mean, in that one, we saw, you know, cover after cover after, you know, cover. And in this one, I think we've had maybe at the most two covers. I mean, most of it's just been ground and pound. Oh, and
there's the boot.
Yep, there's the high kick in the corner. Signature MVP.
MVP getting some momentum build up here.
Oh, look at the chop block right to the back of the leg.
Oh, and drop kick right to the back of the head. And now all
MVP
of a sudden,
beginning
momentum,
to fire up.
Yeah, all of a sudden, the momentum shifting into MVP's corner is almost. He almost got Mike Bennett.
Yeah, but almost isn't enough, and he knows that.
Oh.
Well, Mike, oh, look at MVP. What's MVP thinking here?
Oh, my!
Oh! A top rope 450 splash.
Nicely done there.
And look at Mike Bennett come back like it didn't even faze him. Oh, what's MVP thinking here?
Something.
Dangerous up there on the top rope.
Double underhook suplex. Double underhook superplex off the top rope. Is that enough to put Mike Bennett away?
That
might be it. Oh, and Mike Bennett kicks out it too.
Wow. And look at MVP. I mean, I'm thinking the same thing. What's he got to do? I mean, he just hit him from the top rope and Mike Bennett kicked out. Is there anything MVP can do to take Mike Bennett down?
Not sure. Could very well be.
Ooh! Kick right to the mush.
Kick right, yep, just like you said, kick right to the mush. Maria been kind of quiet out there, cheering on her husband, and who just kicked out at two again. What's the MVP thinking here? He's a little loopy. Good reversal.
Oh, nice suplex there by MVP. And now all of a sudden, MVP seems to be getting the second wind.
Oh, look at that. Missed. Couple of double misses here. Oh, MVP. Belly to belly suplex. MVP missing right there. I'm guessing you guys are. I'm guessing you guys are in all of this because you guys are really quiet over here.
Well, I mean, it's hard not to be. I mean, you're seeing all of this offense that these guys are hitting each other with, and it's really a puzzlement that at this point one of them has not been able to beat the other.
Absolutely.
It's a lot like the Roman Reigns Seth Rollins match we saw a little bit ago. I mean, those two just threw everything at each other but the kitchen sink, and both were getting frustrated, both wondering what they had to do to, you know, put their opponent away, and this match is very similar to that.
It really is.
Oh! I'm not sure what that was, but that was almost like a collision in midair benefiting Mike Bennett. Oh! Good takedown, and there's Maria. Clapping and cheering on.
Oh, my goodness. Mike Bennett grazing the front of MVP's face with his boot, and oh, look at this. Might be setting him up for some kind of a submission here. Oh!
Boy, MVP's head bounced off the canvas hard, and
I think MVP is bleeding. I think that just broke his nose.
Definitely something. MVP with the powerbomb.
That made him mad. Oh, look at this. He's not going for the cover. Instead, he decides he's going to make Mike Bennett tap out.
Will he tap out, though? That's the question.
He's able to fight out of it.
MVP best not get distracted with Maria. Not sure what MVP's thinking here.
Not sure either. Not sure he knows. Oh, now he's gonna go up to the top rope.
Get out of the way, Ernest! Get out of the way!
Oh, nice! Oh. Nice moonsault.
Right,
look at Mike Bennett! Nice reversal!
Reversal onto a pinning bridge here.
Oh!
And oh! Almost.
My goodness! So close. Oh, wait, what in the world? Mike Bennett's got something planned. There's that uppercut.
Big time uppercut by Mike Bennett.
I just floored MVP.
Remember, MVP already has his nose broken.
We think it's broken. It's busted in some way.
Uh-oh.
Miracle setting him up.
Powerbomb pinning combination once again. Referee taking his sweet time.
Yeah, he did.
And, look at this.
Oh,
ow.
Turnabout's fair play.
So MVP, yeah.
Oh, and a nice job there by MVP to grab the leg and reverse that submission.
Oh, kick, elbow right to the midsection. Uh-oh.
Ooh. Oh! Knee right to the side of the head.
What could MVP be thinking?
I mean, one of these guys has got to hit each other with a big-time move because everything they've thrown at each other has not seemed to work. Oh, I thought he had it.
I did too.
And so did MVP. MVP not happy. I mean, we clearly saw Ernest Wright's hand come down and hit the mat, but then he waved it off.
Had to have been at least like a split second, even. We're talking down to the last thousandth of a second he kicked out.
Oh, there's a forearm.
Well, what's Mike Bennett thinking here? Look at this. Oh, nice neck breaker.
Yeah, back breaker, neck breaker combo.
Oh, is Mike Bennett signaling the end here?
Could be. Couple of shoulder blocks.
Very reminiscent of John Cena there.
I was just going to say. Oh, there's the super kick. Lights out. Good night. Ball game.
Is it enough?
What?
Oh, my goodness.
Are you kidding?
This is unreal.
Exactly.
All right, somebody order two kitchen sinks right now because they need to throw that at each other, apparently.
It's the desperate need, a desperate want to be number one contender. And oh, what another kick right to the chest.
What a showing for these guys. Their first debut matchups here on Raw. And
putting on a five-star match.
No doubt.
Oh, MVP. Oh, what a reversal by Mike Bennett. Wow. Wow. Adding insult to injury, is that enough to put MVP away? And now MVP kicks out again.
My goodness. It's getting to the point where I'm going to be more surprised when the referee's hand comes down for three than for when someone kicks out.
Right? I'll agree with that.
Mike Bennett setting up for something.
Another reversal. Oh, my, look at Mike Bennett. What's he thinking about now?
That's the uppercut.
Another uppercut. That's gotta be it now.
I don't know. Oh,
got him.
He
did
get it. But what a grueling matchup that was. Good heavens.
And Mike Bennett advances in the tournament as well.
Yes, he does.
Stay tuned. Stay tuned. We still got a lot more to come here on Monday Night Raw. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to Monday Night Raw. After one hell of a match we've seen just a little bit ago, up next we have some women competition here. We got the Raw Women's Champion Victoria gonna take on Alexa Bliss in a non-title match.
What night it's been already. I mean, some classic matchups tonight. Five-star matchups between Seth Rollins, Roman Reigns, and then the one we just finished up there with the Miracle Mike Bennett and MVP. I mean, I'll tell you what. We haven't even gotten to our main event. We've already seen two main events here tonight.
Yeah. Remember the comment Alexa Bliss made last week on Raw? Said she's getting her opportunity, but in an iron title match to face Victoria.
Alexa Bliss has talked the talk. Now we gotta see if she can walk the walk and back up her words. See what she can bring to the table against the current women's champ.
I don't know about you, but Victoria's theme song is very catchy.
I don't know. I feel the same way about Rich Swann.
Oh, my favorite music.
And our technicians are messing with Kyle again. Alexa Bliss making her way down to the ring.
I think it was simply that Kyle's mic died because Alexa Bliss came out of the ring.
Right.
Well, my heart stops a little bit every time she comes out to the ring, so it makes sense.
Alexa, I hate to bring this up, Kyle, but I don't think Alexa Bliss has won a match since she's actually been on the show.
No, she hasn't.
Oh, you sound so disappointed.
He's obviously been keeping the score.
Yep. Could tonight be different for Alexa Bliss? Could she finally pick up that elusive victory? And more importantly, over Victoria.
Yeah, I mean, if she wins, I mean, there's no doubt that would put her right in the title picture.
I didn't know she was watching the Rumble last night.
Yeah, so hold on, ready to start out the match, and oh!
Nice Enziguri.
Maybe if you work up the courage to actually talk to her, Kyle, you can ask Alexa if she can help you.
You can ask Alexa.
Ask Alexa, the dyslexia. Ask her if you, if she can teach you some of the wrestling moves. Maybe you can apply them at a later date.
Oh my God, I can see it now. Kyle Matthews does the twisted. Oh my God.
Yeah, do a twisted bliss off the top rope. Yes, that would be.
And then he breaks his leg.
First, check and see if you have health insurance, because we know y.W.c. doesn't provide it.
Yeah, if you break your leg, you're screwed.
Nice suplex by Alexa Bliss, in control of the champ right now.
Yeah, right now she is. We've seen before, though, Victoria able to mount offense later on in the matchup, so you gotta wonder if, you know, the longer this matchup goes, if it's going to favor the champion.
That's true. We'll have to wait, definitely wait and see. Victoria's now coming into play, going to already try to pin Alexa Bliss. Gets only a one count out of it, though.
You're not going to put Alexa Bliss away that quickly.
Oh, Alexa reverses. Nice reversal.
Yeah.
Kyle, stop daydreaming.
Wait, what?
Stop it. Well, stop it before I smack you. Ooh, Victoria trying to add insult to injury there. Step on it. Now Victoria on the top rope right into a leg drop.
Right across the throat area of Alexa Bliss.
Victoria has been, without a doubt, one of the toughest women's champion on either show thus far.
Yeah, there's no doubt about that. I mean, Victoria...
Oh, that's another... Speaking of that, don't forget, Roadblock. We're going to see Victoria versus Nikki Bella.
Yeah, that should be interesting.
Yeah, that'll definitely will be. Dropkick by Alexa Bliss, right to the back.
Alexa getting fired up here.
5 feet of fury, she calls herself. And you can see it now, getting all kinds of momentum built up, but Victoria able to fight back.
Oh, side Russian leg sweep there.
Snapmare takedown there by Alexa Bliss, and now just raking, looked like the nose and eye area of Victoria.
Alexa's actually been a lot more dominant in this match than any other,
really
than any other woman.
Oh boy.
Any other, she's been more dominant than any other woman I've seen against Victoria.
Oh, this is not going to be good for either woman.
Uh-oh, Kyle, get ready to go check on her. Kidding, don't do that.
Superflex.
Kyle, sit down. Sit.
You gotta pull out all the stops here against the champ. Alexa Bliss did. Is this enough to knock Victoria off? Kick out at
two. No, it isn't. Kyle, sit down before I handcuff you to your chair.
Alexa setting her up for...
Oh, and a punch to the gut. Uh-oh. Victoria set up for the Widow's Peak.
And she hits it.
To Alexa Bliss.
Ball game.
Is it enough? That's the question.
Has to be.
And it
indeed
is.
It is.
Victoria picking up a win once again here on Monday Night Raw.
Alexa Bliss putting on a good showing here, but just shows the power of Victoria. Just so hard to overcome.
Well, it's gonna our main event to come here on Monday Night Raw. AJ Styles, Triple H go at it one more time for the Raw World Championship. And it's coming up right after these commercial breaks. Guys, it's gonna be a hell of a match.
You bet.
Stay tuned. It's time, ladies and gentlemen. The rematch we've all been waiting for since the Royal Rumble last night. AJ Styles gonna try to get his championship back here tonight.
Phenomenal one versus the game, part three.
If you think about it that way, it's true. We got AJ and Triple H tied, so tonight could be kind of like the tiebreaker. I tried to talk to AJ Styles backstage before the show started. He didn't really have much to say except that he's coming to get back his title. Triple H doesn't want any.
How could you have something to say when you have a curveball thrown at you? You don't find out until the matchup begins that you're defending your title in an Extreme Rules matchup.
Yeah, it's very true.
Now, this is not an Extreme Rules match, is it?
No.
We think.
Well, we think.
We may get surprised. Who knows?
Now, I'm actually being told in my ear now by General Manager Michael Norman that this is a normal match. Triple H, a 15-time champion. I saw Triple H backstage showing off his title belt with his new side plate. The side plate looked pretty cool. Now he's hoping he can just be able to keep that title around his waist by the end of the show tonight.
Yeah, this is the battle between these two, not only for the championship, but also for the opportunity to defend said championship at Fastlane, and if possible, if they're able to retain there, at WrestleMania itself.
To prove himself tonight.
I mean, it seems very odd to think of Triple H with a conscience, but I don't know. Maybe he didn't feel that he completely earned the title last week. I don't know. I can't get into the mind of Triple H.
The Raw World Championship on the line here tonight. AJ Styles pacing in his corner. He's been waiting this rematch. He's been awaiting this rematch since he lost the title last night. And over there, Triple H, the man who you said possibly with a conscience, the cerebral assassin. I mess up my L's, guys, calm down.
I didn't say anything.
The cerebral assassin. There you go.
There you go.
The cereal.
I was missing an R.
No, wait, that's
cereal.
The new day. Never mind.
Speaking of cereal, had myself some Bootios this morning. You know, Bootios, they make sure you ain't booty.
against Ernest Wright, who's had quite a night. That rhymed. Shut up.
Oh, and the match is underway.
AJ Styles right out of the gate with a nice takedown there on Triple H.
Nice takedown there. Jane wrestling at its finest. Triple H with a go behind. And AJ Styles quickly reversing into a headlock. And a knee right to the back. Ooh, a good snap suplex there by AJ Styles. I think he wants his title back.
I think he does too.
Showing a lot of aggression here early on. Triple H able to fight back.
Now Triple H, being just a regular one-on-one matchup, we get to see what these two truly bring to the table without having the luxury of bringing weapons into play. You know, actually, I was thinking, I was thinking when I said part three between AJ Styles and Triple H, that's actually incorrect. It actually is part four, because if you think about it, AJ Styles has a pinfall victory over Triple H. Triple H has a pinfall and countout victory over AJ Styles.
That's true. AJ Styles looking to tie it up. With the championship win. For all we know, these guys could end up trading the championship back and forth all the way to Fastlane.
They could. They could very well.
Oh, look at that. Kick right to the leg. Right to the knee of AJ Styles.
Oh, AJ. I think he was going for a backbreaker or something. Triple H able to kick him right square in the face.
Now the elbows. Oh! What a gut buster.
You know, as many times as these two have faced off against one another over the last couple of weeks, you would think that these two have each other scouted out pretty well. And what a pile driver by Triple H.
Triple H pulling out all of the band moves. I mean, hell, we saw Seth Rollins use the curb stomp twice earlier. One time on Roman Reigns, the other time on the referee.
And Kyle, you bring up how many times these guys have faced each other. They're finding more ways to continue to evolve themselves, be able to counter each other's moves, be able to deliver even more offense on each other.
With AJ. AJ almost maybe thinking Styles clash. Oh, he's got Triple H up. He's going for something here. Oh! Back of the head off the knee. And look at Triple H trying to get out of the submission. Oh, what a right hand.
I thought AJ Styles was going to try to pull a John Cena and hit Triple H with the attitude adjustment.
Well, Styles has faced off against Cena too.
Hey, look, we're on TV, guys.
Hi, Mom, I'm on TV. Now AJ delivers the backbreaker.
What a backbreaker. Oh, is AJ thinking phenomenal form?
Could very well be. He's ushering Triple H up.
Could be thinking.
And he
hits it. Phenomenal forearm.
Right on the mark.
Is that it? New champion. Are we going to see it?
Oh.
Oh.
Really?
That's the second time tonight that the refs counted to three and waved it
goodness.
Off.
Oh, boy, that curb stomp really has an effect. It's really had an effect on him tonight, apparently.
Oh, AJ was going to try to think of go behind, what's that called? I'm not sure. But look at this. Spine buster on AJ Styles.
And this is what Triple H used last week to get himself in a position to put AJ Styles away.
Crowd getting behind Triple
H. Yeah, they are.
Oh, what's Triple H thinking here? Is he thinking pedigree?
He's setting him up. He's got the arms hooked.
And pedigree to AJ Styles.
It's
is that enough?
Right
to retain the title.
And it's over.
Give Triple H credit. This time, no weapons involved. It's a plain one-on-one matchup, and the game came out on top.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for joining us on Monday Night Raw. We will see you guys for Thursday Night SmackDown.